Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with a very important topic, the topic about the independent directors issue. Now in order to understand this, we need to understand three important aspects. The first about the Cyrus Mistry and Ratan Tata conflict. And then we need to understand the importance of independent directors. Independent directors. And then we need to understand the changes to be done in corporate governance. So out of these three, the most important is the third one, changes to be done in corporate governance. Now before we understand this, let us discuss the issue about Cyrus Mistry and Ratan Tata. So Cyrus Mistry was the chairman of the Tata group, the Tata Sons. Now Tata Sons is a parent company, is a parent group that is looking over the entire Tata conglomerate, the entire Tata empire. The Tata empire consists of about 100 companies. Now these 100 companies, management is done by a single chairman, and this chairman of the Tata Sons is also the chairman of the sub companies existing in this Tata group. Now he has been removed unceremoniously, and because he has been removed, there are a lot of questions being raised about how the corporate governance is being conducted in India. Now apart from this issue of removing him unceremoniously, there is another important issue involved in the corporate governance, that is about the independence of the independent directors. Now before we understand the issue of independence of independent directors, let us discuss what is meant by independent director. Now anybody can be an independent director if he or she will be appointed to the board of directors of a company. Now independent director, in order to be an independent director, one should not have any kind of pecuniary relationship with the company. One should not be providing services to the company. One should not be getting services from the company. One should not be a shareholder of the company. So one must not have any kind of relationship, be it economic, be it pecuniary, or be it service related. One has to be completely independent. Now why independent directors are appointed in the companies? Now independent directors are appointed in the companies so that the public is assured of the transparency in the conducting of the affairs of a company, so that the public is assured of the accountability, so that the public is assured that somebody independently is asserting control over the misfeasance and malfeasance taking place in the company. Company mein jo bhi kuch bura ho raha hai, usko control karne ke liye ek independent director wahan pe hai. Now let us also analyze this from the legal perspective. Now as far as the company law 1956 was concerned, there was no article, there was no section about this independent director. So this entire Companies Act 1956 was silent about this independent directors. But the Company Act 2013 has changed this scenario. It has accorded a place to the independent directors. It has defined who can be an independent director. It has defined the importance of an independent director in corporate governance. It has defined the functions that an independent director should be and would be performing. So the things have been put in black and white about the independent directors. But of late, in the Cyrus Mistry and Ratan Tata conflict, we have seen how Nusliwadiya, an independent director, has been removed from the boards of Tata Cars, from Tata Chemicals, and from the board of Tata Steel. Now, why are we discussing that the independence of the independent directors is at stake? It is at stake because when we look at the entire structure of the companies existing in India, most of these companies, about 80% of these companies, more than 80% of these companies, they have a shareholder in the form of a majority shareholder. Now, what is meant by a shareholder in the form of majority shareholder? Now, it means, suppose a company is named as A, and in this A company, you have somebody as a majority shareholder who is holding more than 50% of the shares, who is holding about 60%, 70%, 80% of the shares. Now, even if you will be having independent directors, suppose you are having 2/3 of the independent director, even in that case, when it comes to the counting of the votes on the certain issues over which the board of the directors will be deliberating, in that case, the independent director's voice will not be considered substantive. It will not be able to do justice to the concerns of the multiple stakeholders. So, it will be a futility, it will be useless to have anybody on the board as independent director until you are having big shareholders in the company. You are having mega shareholders in the company. You are having ultra shareholders in the company. So basically, what we need to do, we need to reform corporate governance. We need to alter this. Alter the CB should come out with the new corporate governance rules by which the multiple, the big shareholders, they should not be asserting themselves over the transparency. They should not be asserting themselves over the accountability. They should not be asserting themselves over the control. Now, why this is important? This is important because India is new to this market forces. It has been just 25 years that we have begun to romance openly with the market forces. Because it was in 1990, we have completely liberalized Indian economy. So there is need to come out with new rules and regulations by which the independence of the independent directors should be assured. So the interest of the multiple stakeholders are protected. Now this is important from IAS examination point of view, plus also important from interview point of view. You must prepare a question on this. In order to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. If you want to read it in the form of a synthesized pattern, just read Brainy Map on this very issue. So, but this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.